In the early 80s, I was playing Little League Baseball. And one season I was having a terrible time. I think I struck out 6 times in my first 6 times at bat. So my father took me out and threw me some pitches and immediately identified that I was turning my head way away from the ball. And he pointed this out to me, and as soon as I started tracking the ball or pointing my head at the ball, I immediately got better, did much, much better, and the season went fine after that. So I decided right then, if I ever got the opportunity to look at this problem scientifically, head and eye tracking in baseball, that I would. The three main pieces of this are the pitching machine. The second piece is the head tracker. And then the third piece is the eye tracker, which is a video system, uses video cameras to monitor where your pupil goes. I think what we wanted to find out was whether people kept their eye on the ball. And then the second kind of the follow-up to that was, how do they do it? Do they do it mostly by turning the head, or mostly by turning the eye, or by turning both? In our data, it's mostly done with the head. A little bit with the eye, but mostly with the head. We have two things in mind. One is, we want to get more data when people are actually hitting, because most of our data has come from just following the ball. The second thing that we want to do is really nail down what the differences are between novices and experts. As I said, our pilot data seems to demonstrate there are differences, but we'd like to really quantify what those differences are. There are so many advantages to Ohio State. Everybody at Ohio State that I've ever come across, if I've asked them a question, they always get back to me. They always help. I've never had a situation where someone would say, sorry, too busy, or something like that. That just doesn't happen at Ohio State.